Hello everyone, I'm Antsa and welcome to Let's Play the Need for Speed for Sega Saturn. Alright. Pioneer Productions. I don't get it why old CD games used to have live action footage, but then when the quality got better in the second millennium, they stopped using live action footage and instead prefer pre-rendered videos. But anyway, let's check the options. Tournament. Why not? Coastal. Right, the most difficult task. Okay, so I have the Porsche, that's Viper and Corvette. Some car porn. Ow. Ooh, it's almost 15 frames per second. Let's get this on. And just to remind, I haven't played this game. I used to have the Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. What? This was automatic. Okay. Manual it is. No problem. Oh, now it's automatic. Interesting. It's a bit dark. Maybe I should have chosen the midday. Some flickering there. Change the camera. There. I prefer the onboard camera. Get out of the way, you morons! Ah, shut up. Oh no. This is interesting. Angle. Wait a second. Which button breaks? Well, this is a handbrake, obviously. Okay, I think there's the brake. Let's use handbrake. Oh no. It's too cocky. At least there's no time limit. Like in the arcade games. Honestly, if these graphics would be a little bit sharper, not so blocky, there's nothing wrong with this game. Even modern racing games have basically just the road you follow. Alright. Finished last, no surprises there. But yeah, there's not much you can do when designing a racing game. There's a road that you follow, and then you race against the other players. So the only other thing you can do is create a open world racing game. And even then, you have racing sequences. Okay. I have to learn to use the handbrake if I want to win. Okay, slight touch handbrake is enough. If you hold the handbrake, then you will spin. The background is also very nice. Okay, that's a bit too much hot air balloons. Should be dangerous even to have such a number of balloons. I know how to use the horn. Aha! It doesn't. Okay. There's a turn coming up. Whoa, what was that? This game is famous for its crashes. See any good places for crashing? The music is so 90s. Some destructible environment. Very impressive. They even got the shadows right. Maybe they are pre-rendered. At the finish. Sure. Bottomless pit, or that of course should be the sea. I see. Okay. Now, compared to previous racing games, this was pretty realistic. Not... Oh yes. Not only the graphics, but also the physics. Because most arcade games, racing games, have this unrealistic acceleration. So you just press acceleration button and then it takes 2 seconds and you are at top speed. But here it takes nearly a minute. To reach the top speed. And that's only possible if you are going the straight road. So here, for example, you cannot go very fast. shadows for morning sunrise are obviously fake. The sun is playing its shadows from above. So they have only applied some dark filter. Render it to look like morning. It's like old films that simulate night time. They just put some dark filter front of the camera, so it looked like it was night time, but obviously you could see the shadows. There seems to be some rubber band AI going on. It didn't took that long time to reduce the gap, but then it's difficult to gain the top positions. But anyway, was that the last stage?
Congratulations! You've got a top 10 time for this track!
Oh, really? Alright, let's put my name. Cool. But unfortunately we did so bad that there probably won't be any surprises for us, like a new car. Okay. Alright, let's continue next time. Bye bye.